I'm guessing that probably your sewing machine has a lot of decorative stitches there that you never use. And that has been my case. I'm going to share with you how you can use this decorative stitch on a facing and sew it on the reverse so that it is exposed. It could end up being a really beautiful detail you can add to some of your fabrics that are just solids and you want something extra there on your piece. So keep watching, it'll be very practical. Hi sewing friends, I'm Karina from liftingpinsandneedles.com. Welcome to this channel that is all about sewing, limitless sewing. And I've mentioned before that I've usually always had very basic machines. Back in 1990 when I got my first Singer machine, even that one had a few decorative stitches there. I've always looked at them and thought, what are they for? Like, I have no use for them. Literally, that's what I've done with every single machine I've had. I basically use a straight stitch. I move the needle either to the left or to the right. I use a zigzag stitch and buttonhole settings. That is basically the only things I have used with all of my sewing machines. And the one I have now is no different. The one I have now is 3 years old. It's just a mid-range machine, electronic, but nothing too fancy. There's also a load of stitches there. Some are functional, like stretch stitch and other things. But there are some that just look decorative to me and I thought, why not give this a go? It's something I've had in my mind to do for ages. And actually, it's the first time ever I've used a decorative stitch in 30 years of sewing, believe it or not. And basically, I just want to embroider a piece of fabric that I plan to use for my facing on a top that I'm sewing. Now, this can be any top that you're making. You know, the facing could be round if you're doing a round neckline with a facing. Or it could be a V with a V facing. In this case, my top has a V neckline with a V facing, but the technique won't change, the idea won't change. And I'm not focusing on any specific pattern in this video. I'm just giving you an idea that you can use with anything you want. Although you will see this garment in the very near future, I am still not at liberty to share what garment it is, although I'm just going to share with you what I did with the facing. I really enjoyed thinking this up and doing it. It is a red linen, mostly linen in the blend. I thought that this decorative stitch there would look very pretty. I'm keeping it the same tone. I am doing the stitches with a red but in a darker tone than my fabric. I am pretty sure I would not want to do this with a contrasting color, just my aesthetics. I think keeping it the same just might make it look more subtle. I don't want it to be so in your face. I want it to be a subtle detail. I am sure you probably have a lot more decorative stitches than I have. I mean, some of you might even have machines that embroider really nice things, and this idea could work for that as well. So let's hop in to see how to make a facing exposed, make it the center of your garment, do some subtle decorative stitches there, make it really pretty. Let's see. Don't you think this is starting to wear me? You've been rated down like hell. I knew I would be sewing these embroidery stitches on interfaced fabric, so I interfaced a scrap just the same as my finished facing would be, and I tried every single decorative stitch in my sewing machine. There weren't many, and I settled on the one that has the white there. I thought it was nice and subtle. I then interfaced enough fabric that would fit my facing pieces. There is my front V and my back facing. Both of those pieces have already been interfaced. And you can see I'm going to lift now. I've made lines with a friction pen 5/8 of an inch apart. And that is to guide my stitching with the decorative stitches. I want to do that really accurately. And I've done that for the back and for the front. For the front, I made sure to make a line right at the center and up on the top where you are going to unite the shoulder seams. I also wanted the lines to be exact so that my decorative stitches will sort of match on the shoulder seams. Not that it's going to be too visible, but in that corner intersection, there is a line going down. And then I went to my sewing machine and placed the needle of my presser foot along the line that I can see. You know, the friction pen mark will erase with heat. And then I just had a long relaxing time. This does take a while, and I just went ahead and stitched along every single line that I had drawn here on my facing. So I'm going a bit longer. I haven't yet cut my facing. I just want to embroider a little bit larger than the size of the facing, and I went and did that for the back, just going up and down, up and down.
Now, you can choose whatever distance between them you want. You don't have to do them in rows. You can do them across. You can do freehand. You can do whatever you want. I just wanted mine to be in vertical rows, super subtle. And I practiced and figured out that 5/8 of an inch was the distance I thought looked pretty. Not too on top of each other and not too further apart for a small area that would just be the facings. So that was fun. I did that on the back and the front. It took a pretty long time, so I can imagine how longer it would take if you wanted to do huge pieces. I think I would keep this to a minimum just to do it on small pieces of a garment. My machine is not automatic. I can't just leave it embroidering on its own. I have to actually guide it because my machine is basic. Whatever machine you have, I'm sure you can do this. I'm looking forward to trying this again. This was pretty fun and it's a really nice detail to add to a facing piece. This is how the piece of fabric looks for the back facing. You can clearly still see the outline with a friction pen where I need to cut it. That's how it looks. It's super accurate. It's very neat. It's still the same shape and size as the original facing piece. I made sure to compare that before cutting it. There is the back and there is the front. And now you do the same thing that you do for any facing from any pattern. You sew at the shoulder seams you're facing. You also sew the shoulder seams of the top you're making. The seam allowance can vary. In this case, I'm using a 1/2 inch because that's what the pattern has. Once I've got the facing already assembled, sewn at the shoulder seams pressed, I did a guide stitch that is 1/4 inch from the edge. That's how much I want to fold that raw edge in. That's how it's going to look on the outside. And now at the bottom where the point is, that's where I've fiddled a lot, and I've actually trimmed away some bulk there to make sure that it's super crisp at the bottom. You know, I'll always do a little bit of hand basting to hold that in place very neatly. That way I can be sure that my V on the front where the facing will be visible will be super crisp. Now you can align your completed facing to the neckline of the top you're making. Make sure the shoulder seams match for the facing and the neckline. And this is where it seems really wrong, but the right side of the facing touches the wrong side of the top. Now on the edge of my neckline, you can see some white peeking out there, and that's because instead of stay stitching, I fused on a little strip of interfacing. The seam allowance is 1/2 inch, so you need to make sure that strip of interfacing is very narrow, like 1/4 inch, so it will be completely hidden in there if you choose that option. Otherwise, if you stay stitch, you also need to stay stitch within the seam allowance so that you don't see that on the right side of the fabric. After doing all that prep work, then you can align your facing to your neckline piece. I like to mark at the V point and draw the seam allowance so that I can be super, super accurate there and not just guide myself on the seam allowance of the metal plate under there. It's really easy to make a mistake there, and what you end up there is with a V that's not very well centered. So just drawing that seam allowance won't hurt you. It's a friction pen, it will come out. It will help you stop right at the lower V point and pivot and get a really nice accurate result. Then you just continue sewing this facing all the way around. After sewing the facing on, we go to the V area and we snip right up to the V, but not through it, as close as you can. And now I'm just going to trim the whole seam allowance a little bit shorter. It's 1/2 inch. I'm trimming it to 3/8 right here. I just think 1/2 inch is just too much to be able to go around the curves, and it'll just be too bulky on a facing. After doing that, I want to grade the seam allowance, which is trim one layer of these two slightly shorter than the other. What you want is that the layer that will be on the outer side of the garment be the longer. I'm flipping this over and you can see that the interface side, my facing, is the layer that will be on the front of the garment when worn. So that is the layer that I want to leave longer. That means I am trimming the layer that is not interfaced, the layer of the neckline, shorter. So it's just a fiddly process going all the way around the neckline, just making these seam allowances smaller. This is how it looks. The interface side is slightly wider than the non-interface side. When they are together and the facing is done, it'll be less bulky. After doing all the trimming, the grading, I am snipping around all the curved areas of this neckline, which is most of it. You can't skip this step, and it always deserves its place in a neckline construction. Here you can see the top right sides up. You can see the clean shoulder seams there on the top, and now we flip the facing towards the outside. This is what is going to make the facing exposed and be visible from the outside instead of on the inside, which is the traditional way that you do it. We need to understitch that seam allowance to keep all that inside so that you don't have any of the inside of the garment peeping out to the outside. You can see me pinning the seam allowance towards the inside there. When the understitching is done, the facing on the outside will be super clean and that seam will roll to the inside. This is just the same that you would when you're doing a facing that goes on the inside. It's just that everything is opposite, so you got to get your head around everything. But the technique itself is the same. So I've got my blind hem foot that I use for edge stitching. I move the needle to the left. That allows me to guide the seam on the metal ridge there of this presser foot. And then I can sew this super neatly. I start a little further away from the V and then I get to almost the V. So at the V point, I don't actually understitch. I leave a little gap there that is not understitched. And that's just to keep that V nice and clean. After understitching, we can flip this and you can see how clean that V is on the outside, and on the inside it's not understitched the whole way. Linen presses really well and you won't have an issue. The understitching will keep that seam allowance from the shoulder hidden inside without it being seen on the outside, as you can see there. So it serves that purpose too. You can't really skip the understitching on an exposed facing. Once you have that all pressed and neat, you can see if I open that where the seam allowance is, it's towards the outside of the garment but covered by the facing. And that tip that I had already basted, I'm going to do an extra step, which is actually take a needle there and sew this down. I want to sew the bulk of the seam allowances down on the inside and just keep it flat. I just did a few tacking stitches on the inside that won't be seen, that will ensure that that V stays super super crisp, super pointy for the next step, which will be to neaten this up and top stitch it all down. Of course, I have hand basted this. I just cannot fathom not hand basting this so I can top stitch this super neatly. I have done a little extra basting there on the tip to make sure it doesn't move, and again I take my blind hem presser foot, move the needle to the left, and I can top stitch this super super neatly all the way around, making sure to take extra care that the shoulder seams match both the facing to the main top. The shoulder seam of the facing will be visible, so if it's not aligned with the shoulder seam of the top, it won't look that great. That's also a reason why I like hand basting that. And then when you get to the V, I do a little bit of hand cranking, all the care in the world to make sure that V is as nice as can be, because it is a focal point in the front of the garment and you really want it to look really nice. Now, when I started sewing this down, I didn't back tack. I left two threads there, just left them loose. Now I thread them with a needle and I can thread all this to the back and make a few knots at the back just by hand. That means that I won't have the bulk of back tacking along the facing. I really wouldn't want to have that there. It would look bulky and ugly. It's just a few hand knots on the inside, and that means that the top stitching on the outside of the garment looks seamless. You can't tell where it started and where it stopped, and that is something that I like to do with visible areas like this. And that's it.
Super happy with the result. Sewing this facing exposed with that decorative stitching there was just as fun as experimenting on my machine and just testing out all of these stitches that I'd never used before. I played with the stitch length and I did all those things until I was really happy with one that I found was not making my fabric pucker a little. Played with the tension. I did so many things until I found one that was pretty for me, that it looked really flat, that wasn't making my fabric shrink as such, and that was going to look nice. Just nice and subtle, nothing too dramatic. From the side you can see the texture and how the facing looks raised on top of this, because it's on the outside, and the V is super crisp on the bottom, and I think the embroidery details are very pretty, very nice. It's just a way to customize something. You can choose a bunch of embroidery stitches from your machine. I'm sure yours has a lot more than mine does. Mine is very basic, but I was able to find one that I liked and I really love the result. I hope you give this a go. You know, it's coming to summer now. I know a lot of you like sewing things with linen or linen blends. It's a great way to give it something extra when you're just working with a solid color. Give it something extra. Maybe you want to do the decorative stitching in other colors. That's up to you. I kept it sort of the same, so it's just barely there, but there. I can certainly see it and I can really appreciate it. I was really excited to share this with you today because I'm sure that a lot of you could have a lot of fun doing this and just applying this to any pattern, any garment that has a facing. If it doesn't have a facing, you can make one. So go ahead and have fun, and I'll see you again very, 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 very soon. Bye.